Newtown, a small neighborhood in the town of Gainesville, Georgia, created after a devastating F4 tornado ravaged downtown Gainesville in 1936. More than 750 homes were destroyed, at least 200 killed. Afterwards, segregated housing for black residents was built on a landfill next to railroad tracks. As residents settled into their surroundings, it didn't take long for factories to move in. Sonia Wilkins, whose grandmother Ruby Wilkins died from cancer, grew up in the shadows of the factories.
We have the perina behind our house and the yellow dust, so if it get into the pipes and we drinking contaminated water.
Compounding the problem, a metal processing plant, literally in the community's backyard.
The noise that you hear in the background from the recycling plant has always been ever present in this community.
Another presence in the community was the Newtown Florist Club, which was created in the 1950s by local women in the community to provide flowers for grieving families. But over the next few decades, they started to notice a deadly trend.
We didn't realize that so many family members in the same household were dying of cancer.
And that's when these flower ladies became activists.
And the only thing that we had is our voices. And we just had to use what we had because nobody had a roadmap or a rule book at that time on how to deal with environmental racism.
Rose Johnson is the executive director of the Newtown Florist Club. She's lived here since she was 12 and has seen cancer and lupus ravage her community.
Reverend Charlie Sims and Mrs. Conchita Sims, Miss Geraldine, had a really bad case of throat cancer. I just want her to always be remembered. She was such a special lady. Miss Catherine Earls, and she's my auntie. She passed away of cancer, and just a beautiful person.
And the stories go on. Christy Lewis, who still lives in her family home, watched helplessly as her mother died of cancer in 2019.
To see, you know, my loved ones to have to go through that is very devastating to me.
It just makes me angry, and I'm using the word angry because I am angry about it.
When no action was being taken, the Florist Club took matters into their own hands.
The hardest thing really has been that the burden of proof has been on the community. The industry didn't, still doesn't, have to prove a thing.